And happy weekend once again. Hope we are having a great day today. I pray the blessings of the Lord will be upon us in the name of Jesus. Amen. Today I come with a particular title, very, very vital, the presence of God in the life of a Christian. The presence of God in the life of a Christian. The presence of God in the life of a Christian. Before we continue, let us have a word of prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we worship you, we adore you, we glorify you, we thank you for your love, for your mercy. Thank you for what you have been doing for us. Thank you for the cross of Calvary, thank you for redemption, thank you for salvation of our soul, thank you for healing power, thank you for the ministration of the Holy Spirit. We worship you, we adore you in Jesus' name. As we're going through your word right now, Father, minister to us, speak to us, enlarge us, expand the knowledge of us, the knowledge was to know you more and more in Jesus' name. Speak to your people in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Yeah, to those who join me, I really appreciate you guys. Those who are joining me on this live broadcast, I really love you. I pray this broadcast is going to be a blessing to us, and you can share, invite others to join this show, so that we can all be a blessing in this broadcast. In Jesus' name. The purpose of the program is the presence of God in the life of a Christian. A Christian must seek the presence of God to be with him. When the presence of God is with you, you will live to do extraordinary. When the presence of God is with you, you will live to perform miracles. When the presence of God is with you, people, they will testify about you. When the presence of God is with you, people, they will honor you. When the presence of God is with you, you will live for a legacy. When the presence of God is with you, no matter what the enemy will do to stop you to live, to fulfill your dream, it will never come true. If the presence of God is with you, you will live to make your dream come to pass. If the presence of God is with you, you will be a light to the world. When the presence of God is with you, you will live and your life will be a light to other people. When the presence of God is with you, your enemy, they will turn and they will testify the goodness of God in your own life. That will come with this title, the presence of God in the life of believer. I'm going to read the scriptures so that we can see what the Bible is going to tell us about this topic in the book of Genesis chapter 39, verses 2. And the Lord was with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man, and he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. And his master saw that the Lord was with him. The presence of God. And the master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. You can see the presence of God. The presence of God will make you to prosper. The presence of God will make you to be a blessing to other people. The presence of God will make your master to know that it's God in heaven. The presence of God in your life will make other people to turn away from their wicked way and give their life to Jesus. That will come with this title, for you to seek the presence of God in your life. And the Lord was with Joseph. If I may ask you, is the Lord with you? Is the presence of God with you? If I may ask you, is the hands of the Lord upon you? Remember, the Lord is a holy God. He cannot dwell in the dirty environment. Our God is a pure, is a holy, and is a righteous God. He cannot dwell in the dirty environment. If you want the presence of God to be with you, if you want the hands of God to be with you, you must be pure. You must be holy. You must live to please him. In the book of Genesis chapter 39, verse 3, and his master saw that the Lord was with him. If you want the war, the politicians, the businessmen, the lawmaker, the the people, the society to testify that the Lord is with you. You must seek the presence of God in your life. You must seek for you to abide in God's word. To abide in God's word, you must seek to do His will, His commandment, His precepts, His ordinances. You must live to obey the commandment of God. That's why I come with this title, the presence of God. In the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. When the Lord is with you, you have joy. When the Lord is with you, you live a life full of testimony. When the Lord is with you, it makes your work prosper. When the Lord is with you, it causes your enemy to be at peace with you. When the Lord is with you, it gives you hope of eternity. That's why I come this evening to influence you, to remind you that as a believer, you need to seek the presence of God. If you want to live to make a legacy, if you want to live to become, to be a great leader in the society, you must live like Joseph. Joseph, everybody testified that the Lord was with him. Is the Lord with you? Is the presence of God with you? Is the presence of God is with you? Is your neighbor seeing you living according to the will of God? Is the world seeing you living a life that heaven is rejoicing? That's why I come this afternoon, evening. I would like you to seek the presence of God in your life, in your family, in your business, in your career, in anything you're doing. Seek the presence of God, because with God in you, with the presence of God in your life, you will live to make a legacy. You will live to be a blessing to other people. You will live to make impact in the society. You will live to correct the error in the society. You look the life of Joseph in the book of Genesis, chapter 35, chapter 39, verse 4. And Joseph found grace in his sight because of the presence of God. The presence of God in your life will cause people to favor you with pounds, with dollar, with euro. The presence of God will make people to recognize you. The presence of God in your life will make people to celebrate you. The presence of God will give you influence. That's why I come to you this evening with the title, the presence of God in the life of believer. I would like you to think, is the Lord with you? What people testify about you? What is the testimony that the world, that people who have set up evil, people are planning evil against you, people who have set up to destroy you? What is the testimony now? Are they saying that the presence of God is with you? If the presence of God is not with you, my brother and sister, seek the presence of God. By love of God, accept Jesus Christ. Believe in Jesus. Turn away from wicked ways. Turn away from life that is not pleasing God, and then give your life to Jesus, submit to Jesus, like Joseph in the Bible. The Lord was with him. I call you this evening. I would like you to seek the presence of God in your life. The presence of God that will make you great. The presence of God that will make you a hero. The presence of God that will make the world to testify that you are walking in the way of the Lord. That's why I come to you. This title, seek the presence of God. How can you seek the presence of God? By turning away from wickedness, by turning away from your sin. It's not about going to church. We have a lot of churches, church goers, but they are not living their life that is God. We have a lot of pastors. They are just worshiping money. We have a lot of leaders in the church. But I would like you to have a personal encounter with Jesus. Personal encounter with Jesus, it will make you to love other people. Personal encounter with Jesus, it will make you to live a life that pleases God. Personal encounter with God, it will make you to run away from sin, to reject sin, to live a life that pleases God. That's why I come to you. Have you been to Jesus? Jesus only is the way. Have you been to Jesus? Have you turned away from wicked way? Have you turned away from the wrongdoing? Have you said no to the bad gang? Have you said no to the bad association? Have you said no to the bad influence? Have you said no to the group, the cultivating? Have you said no to the bad people that are influencing you negatively? I call you, Jesus only is the way. He died at the cross for you. He paid the price of your sin. then I call you. If you have not been to Jesus, decide right now. Give your life to Jesus. Make your way right. When you make your way right, His presence will come to you. When His presence comes to you, what will happen? You will be great in society. When the presence of God is in you, the world will testify that you are a hero. When the presence of God is in you, you will live to make impact to the society. When the presence of God is in you, when ordinary men think that your life is over, God will start a new journey in your life. When ordinary men put a full stop for your journey, God will start a new life for you. Now I come to you. Have you been to Jesus? You want to be great in the life? You want to live to make impact in this faith? You want to live to make a difference in this faith? You want to live to be a blessing to these generations and all the generation come? You need to take the presence of God by accepting Jesus, by believing in Jesus, by turning away from wicked way and the least please God. I call you this hour. If you die today, what would be your testimony? I love this guy, Mas Moro in Bahamas. The richest, the wealthiest place in the world is the cemetery. Don't die without the presence of God in you. Don't go to grave without Jesus. Accept Jesus. Believe in Jesus. Confess your fault to Jesus and the mighty walk with Him. When you walk with Him, like the testimony of Joseph, I see who testified, and his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all that he did to prosper. When the presence of God is in you, it will prosper the work of your hand, your business, your career. It doesn't matter your career, political career, financial, in anything you want, your God will prosper, your God will open doors for you. That's why I call you. Seek the presence of God. When the presence of God is with you, my dear brother and sister, you will stand before kings. You see, the presence of God was with Joseph. Yes, they tempted him. Yes, they sold him. Yes, they speak about bad about him. Yes, the war turn and say, we'll see that dreamer, we'll see how your dream will be. But this guy didn't focus on what they have happened. He only focused on the presence of God. My dear brother, focus on the presence of God. When the presence of God is with you, your dream will come true. Your dream will come to pass. What's your dream? What do you want to achieve? I'm telling you on this live broadcast, your dream is possible. You can live to make impact. You can live to bring change to society. What is your goal? What do you want to achieve? What do you want to achieve in the world, in society? It's possible when you seek the presence of God. In the book of Matthew chapter 7, verse 7, ask. When you seek the presence of God, when you ask the presence of God, when you know the kingdom of God, everything will come to you. My dear brother and sister on the live broadcast, I love you so much. But I would like you to know, heaven is real. Hell is real. The only way to God kingdom is Jesus. And then to be with God, to have a happy home, to have a complete home, to have a life full of attraction, you must apply the blood of Jesus over your life. You need to apply the blood of Jesus over your ministry. You need to apply the blood of Jesus over your, because the blood has been shed in the book of in the Old Testament. When I see the blood, I will pass over you. And we have the blood of Jesus. It's the covenant blood. The blood 2,000 years ago is still active. The blood 2,000 years ago is still functioning. I call you right now. Apply the blood of Jesus over your life. Apply the blood of Jesus over your household. Apply the blood of Jesus over your family. Apply the blood of Jesus over your career. Apply the blood of Jesus over your influence. Because when I see the blood, I will pass over you. What do you want God to do for you? What is your desire? What do you want to do? What's your goal? It's possible. Seek the presence of God. Live to please God. Live to honor God. When you live to honor God, you say, I will supply all your needs according to your riches. What's your project? What's your goal? You have a dream to have a happy home. It's possible. You have a dream to have a jet. To have a jet that you will support the gospel of Lord Jesus Christ. It's possible. You have a dream to be a blessing to the North America, South America, Africa, Asia, Australia, Europe continent. It's possible when you see the presence of God, you can live to make a legacy. I call you now.
God loves you. He holds you in your hand. In Jeremiah, he said, before you, when you were in your mother womb, I knew you. The Lord has ordained blessings over you. The Lord has ordained blessings over your career. The Lord has ordained blessings over your future. Your future is bright. Your star will shine. But seek the presence of God. But seek the presence of God over your life. Your future is bright. There is greatness within you. There is greatness within you. It doesn't matter what you're passing throughout this season. It doesn't matter what people are talking about you. It doesn't matter the gun they have set up against you because you're star. I'm telling you, you will live to shine with the presence of God in you. You will live to make impact to the society with God in you. That's why I call you. Seek the presence of God. He loves you. He has a plan for you. He has a purpose for your living. He has a reason for existing. Don't give up on God. Don't turn away from God. Live to serve God. Live to honor God. When you live to serve God, He will make you, your life will be a blessing. God will prosper the work of your hand. Maybe you have a project of maybe $20,000, millions of dollars, billions of dollars. Oh, I tell you, when you seek the presence of God, God will lift you up. God will liberate you. God will honor you. And then walk through your dreams. Walk through your dreams. What's your dream? How can you walk through those dreams? Read books. Let good people around you. People that will steer you up. People that you guys can talk about Jesus every day. People that you guys can encourage yourself and tell the world more about Jesus. Get good individuals around you. Individuals that you guys are going to talk more about Jesus. Get them around you. Get good partner. Get good partner that you can associate and make great things for the society. When you do that, God will like with you. To those who join me, I love you all. As I'm going to close this broadcast, there is greatness within you. There is a bright future ahead of you. Your dream is possible. You can make it. But the secret for you to make it is the presence of God. Seek God. Ask God. Honor God. And God will honor you. As those who join me, my brothers and sisters, is people from Finland, United States of America, here in Africa, those who join me, I pray the Lord will reach you. The Lord will visit you. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will honor you. The Lord will give you the best you need. The Lord will bless the work of your hand, your family, your career, your influence, your ministry. The Lord will multiply your work. As the Lord was with Joseph, and prosper him, and make him great, and give him joy, give him testimony. I pray that good God, that God will honor you, that God will make you a hero, that God will make you a history maker, that God will make your life to be a blessing to the society. I call you. It's possible to be that person that God wants you to be. You can make it. Don't give up on your dreams. Don't give up on your dreams. Live, your dream will come true. And as you are living, the Lord will supply all your needs. It doesn't matter what you are passing through. It doesn't matter what people are saying about you. When people are talking about you, you are close to your miracle. So therefore, live to serve God. I love you all. I'm so happy to be with you guys. I pray God will bless you guys. I pray God will honor you. God will bless our country, Nigeria. God will honor your country. God will bless your country. In the name of Jesus. May God bless you. May God cause His light to shine upon you. May God bless you with long life. May God bless you with good health. May God bless you with idea. May God bless you with influence. May God open door in any way the storm is rising against you. May the Lord calm your own storm. In the name of Jesus. I may not know your challenge, I may not know, but God loves you. He will visit you. He will call and impart your blessings upon you in Jesus' name. I love you all. I really appreciate you guys that join me. God bless you in Jesus' name. Jesus only is the way, the truth, and the life. There is no any other way. It's only Jesus. Give your life to Jesus. Believe in His gospel and then live to be a blessing to the society. He loves you. He has a plan for you. He has a purpose for your living. Don't give up working with God. Don't give up working with God because there is greatness in you. Because you born to a purpose. Because you born to make an impact. You born to make new ventures. Like, keep working with God, because in His presence, the world will celebrate you. In His presence, in your life, the kings will honor you. I love you all. God bless you. Thank you for your time. God bless you guys. God bless you. God bless you. I appreciate you guys. I appreciate you guys. I really appreciate you guys for coming. Thank you. God bless you guys. Roger, Gigi, Augustine. Love you all. And Acton, I really appreciate you guys for joining to my podcast. I pray God bless you guys. In Jesus' name. Thank you. Thank you.